I stay give up.
Please tell us about your trademark ponytail.
This is one of the things that kind of made sense, and I ended up doing it because I used to have dreads, but not like you. I used to have like bongo dreads, and I wanted to do this Bob Marley thing. Like when he's on stage, he does that whole. I thought it was so cool, so I wanted to do it. But then my grandfather told me I couldn't have dreadlocks as a Christian male, so I came up with this so I can spin it on stage. I didn't get a chance to spin it because of time, but yeah.
So for all our international viewers who haven't seen you spin it, can you spin it for them?
Yeah, I'll do that shit. Okay, yeah, it doesn't look awesome without music and a crowd, but you know.
And the Kusheshe video, it was a smash hit, especially at the SA Hip Hop Awards. You won Mad Awards at the SA Hip Hop Awards. So let's talk about that. How has life switched up since the SA Hip Hop Awards for you?
It was dope that week, you know, it was the talk of the town. Because we didn't just win the awards, we won the awards against the biggest artists in the country. You know, we won the award against Coolie Chana, which is a monster. We won the award against AKA, which is a monster. We won the award against AKA. We had the big, I mean, not AKA Dalez, which is the greatest comeback in South African hip hop. You know what I mean? Yeah. So it was great for us to take an award against those guys because they are considered as like the benchmark and whatever. So it kind of made people gain a little bit respect for us. But it was just for a week and we went back to the same thing, same struggles, you know, we'll grow.
So you rap in China 95% of the time. So what's it like when you go outside of SA's borders? Does it work for you or against you?
I've been blessed with the ability to perform. So people don't really respond to what I'm saying all the time. Sometimes it's really, I don't know, like the spirit that I have that kind of, you know, it translates into their bodies. I don't know. You know, I could perform, like the other time I was performing in Eastern Cape with Xhosa people and I was rapping in Tswana. They didn't know what I'm saying. But they were vibing with me, you know. So when we're out of the country, it's really more like energy. They kind of respond to my energy, and it works out.
And what do you think about the whole Back to the City festival and how it's grown over the years?
It's dope, man. And I think the sound was so dope this year. So it's growing. The stage is dope. The sound is dope. I hope they grow more. I hope it becomes like a two-day thing, and we could have better sets. We can't perform for 10 minutes all the time.
How many times have you been to Back to the City though?
This is my first time performing at Back to the City as a solo act. I probably came here with Jabba like 3 times or something.
Oh yeah. And can you please talk about your next album and your latest single?
Yeah, my debut album is coming out at the end of March. It's called Tsholofelo. End of May, Tsholofelo, it's out in stores, please go and get it. My next single is probably going to be a track called Puma Gim. I performed it today and people kind of responded, so I think that might be the joint, easy.
And one more thing, can you do the Kusheshe dance for our viewers?
Usually I don't, I'm just tired.
I would. The guys overseas, so we see what we got in Africa.
Now the whole time. So basically, I'm not the master, but this is how it's done, basically. This is dance.
I'm Neo, and we're here at Back to the City 2014.
Hashtag BTTC 2014. Hashtag hip hop, hashtag loser.
That's my name right there, speaking to loser. These are my niggas right here, Back to the City. My cool, my little cool cat just killed it. Fucking made it all go crazy.
Hey, what's up? Yeah.
Been here for like 14 years now. And if we don't okay, we should enjoy ourselves. And yeah, have a good time.
It's about Eddie from Israel, coming from Y, BTTC, sending me like live in, catch me.
We were George Avakian, hashtag Back to the City 2014, hashtag Freedom Day, hashtag
let us get it.
George, please introduce yourself to our online viewers from around the world.
My name is George Avakian.
Went to Ellen Glen High School. Got a younger brother. Big shout out to Rudy, he's my boy from day one.
What do you do for a living?
I do many things. Besides the music, I do dabble in a bit of business.
How long have you been beatboxing? And when did you just start, when did you decide that you want to beatbox as a living?
I started beatboxing when I was about 14 years old. Yeah, that's like, what, how old am I now? 23, yo, it's long, chief. Yeah?
How much cheese, on a scale of 1 to 10, how much money is there in beatboxing?
It just depends how you do it, dog. You can say there's music and there's money in everything. It's just about how you sort of place yourself in the industry. And I think I found my little niche that I'm doing. And yeah, man, I'm blessed.
And do you know why people celebrate Freedom Day?
Of course, my G. I come from Armenian descent, my parents initially, but I was born here, so to me it's such an important thing to be an African. You know, we live together, we are one, and that's just how it is, man. One love, yeah.